called Double. And it's one of the great things about living in an artist building, how inspiring my roommates are on an everyday basis. I walked downstairs one morning and I said to my roommate Bob, I had this weird dream. I woke up with the line, here is a box of fish marked tragedy in my head. And he said, well, that's weird, because I woke up with the line, St. Peter only slept to enter the luminous cave. So, everyone's fault. Double. Here is a box of fish marked tragedy. Is it different from the dream in which your alter ego kills the girl? You are the same, and everyone knows it, whether tracing the delicate lip of the oyster shell or sharpening your blade in the train car. The marvelous glint is the same. Though you think you sleep, you wake and walk into the hospital, fingering each instrument, opening each case with care. The scales fall away with a scraping motion. You are the surgeon and you are the girl. Whether you lie like feathers on the pavement or coolly pocket your equipment and walk away, you are the same, and you are the same. You only sleep to enter the luminous cave. Mm-hmm. Blues. Who guesses the hieroglyph wins? Asleep in the grass, alone in the barn, under a dull sky. Who knows the cliff, the score and its cleft, the stormy or placid after? Shape with a hole in it, tree with a bend in it, bird on a branch, the hieroglyph. Meeting Street. Things fall apart, baskets, wicker or straw, the steady clop of a horse with a policeman on it, and me standing there, staring at a puddle of rain with a pile of shit steaming in it. There's no reason for it either. From the alley I hear a woman calling out, Federico, Federico. And she's lifting up the tin lids on the trash cans. I hear the clatter over all else. For a long moment, the streetlights seem not mechanical, but simply lit. And there's just the rain continuing, the buildings getting taller and taller. I could live a long time faceless like this.